Hello dear chess friends, this is Grandmaster Leonid Krieps for chesslectures.com. Today I'll show you a game from the Rapid World Chess Championship between Van Gaal and Daniil Dubov. Okay, so let's start. White plays knight f3, knight f6, c4, g6, g3, bishop g7, bishop g2, and c6. Very safe move, so the idea is this is not a King's Indian anymore, black wants to play d5, and then there are many variations where the position is roughly equal. So d4, d5, so d4 is actually the most straightforward way to play against it. Now white has a couple of choices. If he takes on d5 and plays knight c3, black has knight e4 immediately, and he equalizes pretty easy. Short castle, as far as I know, is considered to be a mistake because black can take, and now after knight e5 there is this trick, knight g4, so white cannot take on c4 because d4 hangs suddenly. So what white can do is to play b3 or to play knight bd2 like he did in the game. Knight bd2, but the drawback of this move obviously is that the bishop on c1 stays bad, so can't be developed. Short castle. Short castle. Now, understanding that white is going to play b3, black plays a5 in advance already, so that after b3 he always has the possibility to create some play with a4. Alright, still, of course, b3, knight e4. I don't have to play a4 immediately, I can. It's important for me to have this possibility. Knight e4, bishop b2. And bishop f5. So in this position, it's all about the square e4. It's very important to control it. And basically, by developing the bishop, black does it. He says, now, okay, I want to take on d2. And if you take with the queen, then I want to play to put my bishop to e4. And then later play knight e7, knight f6. So white plays knight h4. Take on d2. Queen takes d2. Knight takes f5 doesn't work because I take on f1. So queen takes d2. And bishop e6. And again, this is not a loss of time, because the knight on h4 definitely doesn't stand that good. C takes d5 now makes no sense. I'll take with the c-pawn and then develop my knight to c6. So the only way for white to use this bishop f5, bishop e6, is to play somehow with f4 and f5. And this is what he does immediately. Giving up the pawn. But of course, it is too dangerous to take it because you are not developed. So d takes c4, f5, especially in a rapid, you know, you don't want to play such positions where your king is exposed. Yeah, you are undeveloped. So you want to play safer most of the time. So for this reason, knight d7. Now taking on d5 would make more sense because if black takes with the bishop, then we have e4. And if you take with the pawn, then your knight doesn't go to c6 anymore. However, here the knight can go to f6 and then to e4. So, again, not much what white has here. He decided to play f5. And this is definitely a most natural continuation. But, yes, then g takes f5. And, by the way, so this may be a little bit imprecise. I think bishop takes f5 is stronger because here white has no choice, he has to take twice on e5. In this position, after g takes f5, white can wait, theoretically, because there is nothing that makes him take on f5 immediately. This pawn will not run away anyway. Okay, but he took. Bishop takes, rook takes, e6, rook f1, and f5. So, obviously, a very good move, because now there is no e4. If black would stay back with the pawn on f7, white would simply play e4, but now the square is taken. And in the ideal world, somehow white should try to push g4, in my opinion, to detract the pawn f5 from the control of the e4 square, and once black takes, then white can go with e4, maybe even immediately by sacrificing a pawn, I don't know. Take and d4. Surely white does have compensation here. Yeah, but maybe he can also wait and play some queen f4 or h3, something like that. So in the game, he was very straightforward. C takes d5, c takes d5, rook ac1, putting the rook on the open file, but there are no squares to enter on that file, so it doesn't make much sense. Knight goes to f6. So now I'm controlling all the squares here again, one more time. Bishop f3. Finally, a4, activating my rook. B4 definitely would not, it's not playable, yeah, because you are creating, like, your bishop is really dead now. In addition, also, black can play a3. So this is not something you want. Queen e3. Attacking, queen d7, defending. Rook c2. A takes b3. Why takes with the queen? Because if he takes with the pawn, then I have rook a2, pinning the bishop and creating additional pressure here. Or if I don't want, if I want to exchange a pair of rooks, I can also play rook fc8. So that white doesn't have rook c1, rook c7 plans. So white took with the queen. Rook ac8. Rook fc1. Bishop h6. Rook c8. Rook takes c8. Yeah, and now after all, I think that after rook c8, queen c8, this position is roughly equal. So I don't think white is any worse here, because always he can exchange the bishop for the knight. So this is probably some sort of equality. Queen c3 should equalize easily. Instead, white decides to play for more, rook c5. But this is always dangerous, and if you keep more pieces on board, because you have a weak king, especially in rapid, with a weak king, you don't want to take risks. Yeah, so it can backfire. Alright, so rook c5. Bishop f8. Rook b5, rook c7. So yes, white has pressure against b7 pawn. Black pieces are kind of tied to defense. But white cannot improve his position anymore, because he cannot attack the pawn with more pieces. On another side, the king is still weak, and black may start coming out somehow with his pieces. At some point, maybe even sacrifice the b7 pawn. Rook b6, knight e4. I mean, you can't stand always with the knight at some, on the 6 at some point. You have to do to go to e4 with that. Bishop takes e4. F takes e4. So I think even though white is attacking b7, but the position of black is slightly better, and this is because of the king and because of the better bishop. The king g2, bishop g7. Yeah, d4 is a potential target. And rook b5. It doesn't look like white is getting into much trouble here. However, surprisingly, after queen f7, he starts getting problems, because there is a threat. That's queen h5 attacking e2 pawn, and it's not so easy to protect it. So king, queen h5 is one idea, then rook f7 is another afterwards. E3 may come, the pawn d4 is attacked, the rook on b5 doesn't do anything, attacking on b7 is fine, but my rook will be protecting that. So queen f7, and eventually white starts getting in trouble. So he plays rook b6, bishop h6, and surprisingly this position almost, like, is almost lost. I have very strong threat. I want to play e3. White played queen d1, but then he got bishop e3. And again, I want my queen to go to f2. Queen f1. Queen h5. Of course, no exchanges. And now the best practical chance probably for white would be to play rook b3. Now, if the bishop has to go, that's fine. Then, like, white probably will survive it. The problem is that black has rook f7. White has to give up the queen. King takes. Rook e3, yeah, but he has small chances to make a draw here, but I guess overall, objectively, the position should be lost. Still, would be the best chance. In the game, he took on e6, and then the rest is almost by force. Rook c2, threatening to take on e2, and then on h2, the king h1, rook takes b2, rook e5. So now Black has to take care a little bit because his king is kind of weak too. So he needs to make sure that he doesn't get checkmated by accident. The queen f7, no checks so far. Rook f5, queen e6, rook e5, queen d7. White played queen f6, but his position is already lost and he got rook b1 and gave up because after king g2, rook g1 checkmate. So yes, an interesting game. So strategically, this idea f4, f5 looked very reasonable for white, but black replied with e6 and f5. And even though white had two bishops, but that bishop on g2 was pretty bad. And this is something that happens very often. So like players with white, they overestimate the bishop, the light squared bishop. In reality, that light squared bishop is restricted by black pawns badly and is effectively just a bad piece. So probably trying to activate it by playing g4 somehow would be the best choice for white. All right, I hope you enjoyed this game. This is Leonid Kritz for chesslectures.com, signing out.